Okay. Good morning. Forgot where I was supposed to look for a second. It is, of course, Saturday, December 29th. 29th. There's only 3 days left in this year. My tire pressure is down again because, of course, it is. Great. My hair is sticking up like crazy because it's gotten a little too long and I just haven't gotten the chance to go get it cut yet. And I've got to get to work. I also just discovered that on my next paycheck I'm getting 16 hours of holiday pay, so I can't complain about that given I'm not even working the 2 holiday days that are coming up. Alright, let's go. Look how pale I am. Oh, now I'm red. God damn.
That's me, dude. That's me.
Yeah, so the day is now done, and I'm about to head home. I'm pretty excited to get home tonight, because I've got 3 days off, and one of those days is New Year's Eve, and one of those days is New Year's Day. So, I'm pretty excited. It doesn't seem like much to be excited about, I guess, but I don't know, just being out of this godforsaken building is reward enough. But hey, you know, I got to stow for the last period today, so I was pretty chilled out. I've had a good last 3 hours just by myself, working in the quiet. And it's been nice. So, Taco Bell tonight, of course. So I'll see you there, probably.
3 more friends have arrived. 3 more friends. Technically 2, because one of them is the same person. But look, we've got Cloud Player 1 right here, Bayonetta Player 1, and Bayonetta Player 2. These guys have evaded me for a while. I also just want to say a huge shout out to, well, I'll show it backwards so you can't see the email address, to Shin Naka. eBay name is Shin Naka Momo 1975. That's who I got all of these from. They and their kids sent me some little origami hearts, which is just really cute, and they said, can you take a picture of yourself with them and put it on Facebook? I can't find their Facebook account, unfortunately, but they left an email address, so I'll probably send it to that or just to their eBay page. But it was just really sweet and warmed my heart to open those up, so let's put these guys on the shelf.
Alright, so unfortunately Cloud Player 1 goes on his own little shelf right here next to these guys because, well, just because of the way that this worked out. Now, if it turns out that they only do Squirtle and Ivysaur amiibo, everything here will move right or left one, so then other Cloud will be up here with him. But for now, he's there by himself while Cloud Player 2 is over there. We got Bayonetta Player 1, even though this is the Bayonetta 2 Bayonetta, it is still the Player 1. I'm gonna have to do some moving around over here. And then Bayonetta Player 2. These are some wide amiibo. Yeah, I'm gonna have to, I might only fit 5 in there, honestly. That wouldn't be too bad, though, because that would mean I could move Inkling here and then the newcomers would start here. Let me do that. Yeah, I actually think I like that a little bit better. Just, you know, Smash 4 ends here. And then Smash Ultimate has 3 shelves all to itself. Oh god, that's not gonna be that much room, is it? Because we can fit like maybe 3 more there, because Ridley's a big boy. And then we got 12 more over here, so depending on how many characters they do, oh no. Either way, super happy that these guys are here. The Smash 4 DLC ones evaded me for so long. Well, I mean, except Ryu and Mewtwo and Roy. But these ones that got 2 separate releases for each one, those evaded me for so long, and I'm so glad that I finally have them. The only ones I have in the mail now, I believe, are Kyuubi and Nibiru. I'm not telling you how much I spent on those. I mean, there's some other characters that I've ordered, like the Shovel Knight 3-pack, and Ken, I think, is available for pre-order, maybe? No, it's K. Rool. I ordered K. Rool and I ordered Piranha Plant and Ice Climbers. But they don't come out until February, so once Kyuubi and Nibiru arrive, I will be 100% caught up on the amiibo collection. Except the cards, but that's a different mission entirely.
You know that Thomas guy?
Hey, that.
Yeah, shit.
Let's get him that shit. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, no.
You can please see you.
Nah, that's terrible.
Please, no.
Yes.
Please, God,
yes.
No.
Yes, Kaiba.
Not quite.
Hold on, Yugi. Okay, I gotta give a little bit of context. Josh has just been showing me this clip from the Yu-Gi-Oh! Twitch marathon, where basically Kaiba and Yugi are in a duel because that's what they do, and you just kind of can't tell which turn it is because they just keep doing trap cards and then activating spell cards whenever they feel like it, and then more trap cards, and then hold on, Yugi, and just.
I guess,
well,
I'll try to
sum it up, basically, during the midst of the duel, Yugi had just issued his Slifer the Sky Dragon to attack.
God.
and Kaiba pulled some shit out of his ass that just...
It was large.
Basically... I'm trying to figure out, like, the best way to explain it.
You don't.
Yeah, I don't think
your
you do.
Your Slifer, the Sky Dragon, was deafened by my trap card. It was unable to hear your attack command. God damn it, you.
Applying logic to a children's card game. What's wrong with you?
I'm very, very disappointed.
So I'm just in the process of importing this footage, and I realize that I never ended the vlog. It is that time on the next day. I haven't even started tomorrow's vlog yet, but we'll get there. So when I got in from hanging out with the guys last night, or tonight, I guess, I kind of passed out on the futon until about 3 a.m. and then went to bed at 3 a.m. in the other room, and then didn't get up until about 3 p.m. So, yeah, last night's kind of a blur. Or tonight, for the vlog, you know what I mean. But, yeah, that's gonna be it. I just needed to clarify why this clip is happening the way it is. Tomorrow's vlog will be more of the same, just me right now updating on the day, because I didn't film anything, but I have my reasons, so I guess I'll see you guys then. Thank you all for watching, stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.